Okay, I think it's about 10:30 right now on a weeknight, and I am just getting this fix. So what happened was the derby car was leaking fluid. So we wondered where it was leaking from, and then I saw that it was coming out of the plug on the top of the transmission. So I don't know if you can see this, but you can see right through where the wires go through. So I guess word of wisdom for people doing derby cars, make sure you leave that plug on. That's actually got adhesive that holds the plug together with the male and female, and just cut it. What we did was made the mistake of unplugging it, you know, weight reduction, right? So anyways, fluid was coming out of here, and so I needed something to seal it up. So I thought that you know, I could find like a one of those, what do you call them, I guess the frost plug that goes in the side of the block. Anyways, none of them were the right size, so I ended up taking an MK4 caliper and taking it to a lathe and machining it, so I have 20 thou so on a taper. And anyways, that has, I pounded that into place. I put some caulking in there, and I'm just kind of letting it dry a little bit. The other thing I think that was contributing was that was on a hard kink, so I kind of bent the lines out a little bit. I got a screeching starter. It's looks like the teeth are starting to get chewed up on that new starter. The flywheel looks good, but the starter, I don't know. I guess this is that offset one, and it must not be meshing 100% perfect because it's making a lot of screeching noise. But anyways, so I just pulled those plugs out. I don't need any electrical anyways, but I took that solenoid out of the way, moved it out of the way, put it back now. And so yeah, I'm going to put this pan back on, fill it full of fluid, and it's a lesson learned that that plug right there is what you've got to have, you know, leave that in place for the next time. I've got one more body mount to do, and then I should be fixed up. But yeah, I've got just, this is the transmission. I think this is the 4L60, and this is a little bit longer. So we had to do some drive shaft modification, and this is the one that we had to cut and put sleeve it. And anyways, that's what we did there. Oh, and a new U-joint. So hopefully we put it all back together and it works again, because yeah, before I was just leaking out all the fluid, so yeah, it didn't really want to go forward or backwards, and we were kind of wondering why, but now we understand where all the fluid was going. So yeah, anyways, I never drove anywhere with this thing. I just moving it back and forth and whatnot. And it was a school bus. Where would a school bus be going at this time of night? Anywho, back to work I go. Gotta get her done.